It's too easy and wrong to depict Norway's Anders Behring Breivik as an example of far-right extremism in Europe. His is a philosophy honed online, in hate-filled chat rooms and blogs, that goes much further, with plans for war against a Muslim invasion. But the core of his thinking is very much a part of mainstream right-wing European politics.
There is no doubt that anti-immigrant sentiment and a rejection of multiculturalism in general has been on the rise in Norway, like it has been in the rest of Europe, for the past few years, the past decade. Mr. Breivik, of course, has been part of that very trend.
Across Europe, parties on the far right are gaining real traction, spreading anti-immigration sentiment, backing laws that ban the building of minarets and the wearing of Muslim veils. On the day of the Norway attacks last week, I was in the Belgian Parliament speaking to one right-wing senator who'd part-authored a new law banning the face-covering niqab and full-length burqa.
I'm Christian. I live here for centuries. My family lives here for centuries, generations on. I play the home game, as they say in football. And every right, every freedom, freedom of religion also has its limits.
The senator's views are hardly considered extreme anymore. Breivik himself dabbled in politics, first as a youth member of Norway's opposition and later as a member of the right-wing Progress Party. But as his vision expanded to become ever more apocalyptic, far beyond the realm of political discourse, he left all that behind. The Progress Party continued to prosper in a Europe-wide surge to the right as economic crisis drove resentment towards immigrants.
We want Muslims, Hindus, Christians and others to feel welcome in this country and be able to live here. But we want them to respect Norwegian values of freedom, democracy and respect Norwegian law.
23% of Norwegians voted for the Progress Party at the last election. Beneath the surface here, even in open and tolerant Norway, there is a seam of discontent that runs deeper than many would like to admit. Jonah Hull, Al Jazeera, Oslo.